think it's a stereotype that you have to have studied maths or economics, but actually, you know, there are a whole range of things that you can do and still go into being an actuary.
I did my undergrad degree in actuarial science, and then I went on to do two masters, which helped me cover up majority of the exams. I think that's one of the routes that people take, is to go through the university, get exemptions, and then join a firm.
I would really actually recommend to people to apply for internships and try before you buy, because it's a really good way of seeing if you actually like doing something in practice.
You're working full-time and you have to study exams which are equal or larger than modules at university. So at university you'd have a 3-hour exam, effectively that and a few other exams would be your sole focus for that year. Doing a 9-to-5 job, which actually is usually about 8-to-6, plus study, that's the challenge.
I was lucky actually in the firm that I joined, because they were very supportive when it came to exams, and they give you a lot of study support, you know, time off to revise for exams, study mentors to help you, and money towards materials and then tutorials as well.
Because of passing exams, you sort of get quite structured pay rises and progression, which is really nice, and having that one study day a week is a good transition from studying world to working world.
Qualifying is a great feeling. You go through the process every 6 months, getting the exam results through, and the Institute actually publish a list on the internet of everyone that's passed, and you go through that 15 times, and so the last time that you go through it, when you've realised that you're done and there's no more exams, it's a great feeling.